I'm Barbara Saunders, and I work for the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. And I monitor peregrine falcons in the New York City area. They're an endangered species here in New York State, so we still need to keep track of them and their young every year. And wherever possible, we band them. And so that's what we're doing today. Chris Nadareski with the New York City Department of Environmental Protection is the main person who does the banding. You know, he's been doing this for 30 years and he's just excellent with the birds.
What we try to do is get everything set up in advance so that the disturbance is minimized to the falcons as best possible. You're gonna see once we bring the baby falcons in here, they're gonna be a little bit anxious and they'll probably be very vocal. Just in their surprise, it'll probably be the first encounter they have directly with humans. Okay, we've got one of the chicks that was standing right on the edge here.
They're all
okay. All right, I'm gonna open up now. So what we're gonna do is carefully take one chick at a time and place it in the box. Barbara? We're gonna just put them in here carefully.
The young are be about 3 weeks old, which is a perfect time for banding. The little ones are real cute at this age. They're old enough to be able to tell if they're male or female. The females are a little bit larger than the males, and also their foot and their tarsus are larger. So Chris will be able to put the appropriate band size in each one of them. The adults don't care for it so much. They look at us as perhaps predators, but you know, we only have the chicks out for a very short period of time. We give them a quick health check to make sure there's no health issues, that the eyes are clear, the mouth is clear, the wings are good, there's no lice. So they get a quick little checkup, we band them, and we put them right back. And we have approximately 20 pairs in the New York City area. That's the five boroughs. They like high places, the tops of the bridges, tops of tall buildings, where there aren't a lot of people. They'll stay away from residential buildings for the most part. They like it where it's quiet. Also where they get a good view so they can watch for their prey, especially over bodies of water. We have the perfect environment for them. In the wild, they normally nest on cliff ledges. And so the ledges of our tall buildings and the bridges are basically simulate that. And we've got plenty of food. They never go hungry here in the city. There's never a lack of pigeons or starlings or woodpeckers, robins, whatever was going through. They only eat birds and they catch them in the air. So they've got to be pretty fast when they come down. They've been clocked at over 240 miles an hour. Some people say 260. When they first fledged, it's like children, you know, first learning to walk. They don't know how to maneuver. They don't know how to land. So they will stay with the adults for about a month and a half. And then they will just sort of naturally start wandering off on their own. They stay around the Northeast oftentimes. When they're about 2 years old, they will start finding mates and establishing their own territories.
The outlook is actually very good. We've had a lot of success after the restoration efforts were originally put into place, starting in the early 1970s, right through the 1980s, throughout Eastern North America. And based on the number of breeding pairs of falcons we have in cities and in wilderness areas, it's looking very positive. The federal government has taken the peregrine falcon off the endangered species list, and it's our hope that someday in the very near future that we'll be able to take the bird off the endangered species list here in New York State.